Hello. Today I am going to explain about a famous MCDM method known as AHP, that is Analytic Hierarchy Process. This method can be used to calculate weights of criteria. This is a simple decision matrix with four criteria, that is price, storage space, camera and looks. With five alternatives, each alternative have their own value of criteria associated with them. The first and foremost step in AHP is creating the hierarchical structure, in which goal is kept in the first level. In this example, the goal is to buy the best mobile phone. Criteria is kept in the second level and alternative is kept in level 3. Each alternative have their own value of criteria associated with them. Example, each mobile phone will have their own price or cost associated with them. Similarly, each mobile phone will have their own value of storage space. Second step is to create a pairwise comparison matrix. This pairwise matrix gives the relative importance of various attributes with respect to the goal. If we take this example, how important is price while buying a mobile? Or what is the importance of storage space when we buy mobile phone? This pairwise comparison matrix is created with the help of scale of relative importance. This is the scale of relative importance, in which 1 is for equal importance, 3 is given for moderate importance, 5 for strong importance, 7 for very strong, 9 and extremely important values. The length of pairwise matrix is equivalent to the number of criteria used in decision-making process. Here we have a 4x4 matrix. As we have 4 criteria, that is price, storage space, camera and looks, we will have a 4x4 matrix. The value in the pairwise matrix depend upon the decision maker or the person who want to buy the mobile phone. What will be the value of this cell? For that, some question should be asked to the person who is buying the mobile phone. How important is price or cost with respect to storage space? For a person like me, price or cost is of a strong importance than storage space. If storage space is given X value, then price or cost will be given 5x value. We can see here that for strong importance, a value of 5 is given. Now, next, what we have to do, we have to divide the row element by the column element. Now, here price is the row element and storage space is the column element. The storage space has been given X value and price as 5x. So here the value will be 5x divided by x, which is equivalent to 5. Here storage space is given x value and price 5x, so it will give 1 by 5. For this particular cell, the question asked should be, how important is price or cost with respect to camera? Price or cost is of moderate to strong importance than camera. So, if camera is given X value, price and cost will be given 4X value. So, we can also take anything in intermediate between 3 and 5, that is of 4 importance. That is, moderate to strong importance will be assigned a 4 value. Similarly, we can see here, camera to price will be given 1 by 4 value. Now, how important is camera with respect to storage space? Camera is of equal to moderate importance than storage space. So, if camera is given 2x value, storage space will be given x value. So, here we will get a value of 2. Well, vice versa, storage to camera will be given 1 by 2 value. Similarly, we can assign values to each cell. You can see that the diagonal elements takes a value of 1 because price will be of equal importance to price. The fractional value has been converted to decimal value and the sum of each value is calculated. That is 1 plus 0.2 plus 0.25 plus 0.14 will give 1.59. Normalized pairwise matrix is calculated. All the elements of the column is divided by the sum of the column. Here we can see that 1 is divided by 1.59, 0.2 is divided by 1.59 and so on. This is the normalized pairwise matrix. Here I have calculated the criteria weights. The weights are calculated by averaging all the elements in the row. We have just added all these elements and divided it with the number of criteria, which will give the criteria weight. Next step is calculating the consistency, that is to check whether the calculated value are correct or not. For this, I have taken the same pairwise comparison matrix which is not normalized. I have multiplied each value in the column with the criteria value. So here you can see that 1 has been multiplied by the criteria weight, that is 0.6038. Similarly, 0.2 is been multiplied with the criteria weight 0.6038. Similarly, I have done it for all other values. On solving, we get this matrix. The weighted sum value is calculated by taking the sum of each value in the row. So you can see that by adding all these terms, we will get the weighted sum value. Just I have written the criteria weight next to the weighted sum value. Next, we calculate this ratio of weighted sum value and criteria weight. Now we calculate it for each row. On solving, we get this value. Now lambda max is calculated by taking the average of all these values. Next, we calculate the consistency index CI, which is given by the formula lambda max minus n upon n minus 1. In this example, n is 4 as we have 4 criteria. Finally, we calculate the consistency ratio, which is given by dividing the consistency index with random index RI. Random index is the consistency index of randomly generated pairwise matrix. I have shown the random index table for up to 10 criteria. In our example, the random index for n equal to 4 is 0.90. So I have just calculated the consistency ratio. Since the value of consistency ratio CR is 0.037311, for the proportion of inconsistency CR is less than 0.10, which is the standard, we can assume that our matrix is reasonably consistent. So we may continue with the process of decision making using AHP. Based on the requirement of buyer, these criteria weights can be used by the decision maker for further calculation. So you can see here that price has been given 60% weightage, storage space 13.65% weightage, camera 19.58%, and looks a weightage of 6.46%. Thank you and have a nice day.